episode of Writer's Block. In this week's episode, we will be looking at all things South African hockey and roads hockey. On the panel this afternoon, we have Caitlin D'Souza, who is a Glencross School speech writer, and Katie Campbell, who is a fourth team hockey player, and myself, Samantha Carolus, who is a Glencross mentor and sport speech writer. Alrighty, ladies, thank you for joining us this afternoon.
My pleasure.
To start off our discussion, we will be looking at the AFCON tournament, which took place just last month in Ismailia, Egypt. Both South African teams went. The AFCON is the African Cup of Nations, which sees South African teams battling it out for a spot in the World Cup, or in the Hockey World Cup. Righty, Caitlin, first question for you. What do you think of the final standings of the team, given that South Africa had taken gold for both the men and the women?
Well, seeing as the men and women's team both took away gold, it shows that we have a high performance in hockey in South Africa. Most interestingly is that we've held the title for the men's team since 1993, so we've won gold 7 times consecutively. And then the women's team, we have held the title consecutively 8 times since 1994. Don't know about stuff. Okay, and then it exhibits South Africa's reigning talent in field hockey.
Alrighty. As you had said, South Africa, this is South Africa's 7th consecutive win for the women's team and 8th consecutive win for the men's team. What do you think gives South Africa the edge over the other teams, and why are we winning so consecutively?
Well, I think most interestingly is that in South Africa it's still considered to be an amateur sport, so hockey is not a paid profession. A lot of the people that play as a professional sport actually do get paid, such as our Proteas or our Springboks. They get paid to be able to go overseas and competing in that sport. Whereas our teams that are on the hockey side have to actually pay to be able to be sponsored, or have to pay to actually go overseas and compete. So it just shows that our dedication is right up there amongst the best of them, and that we really do try and pull out all the stops in order to win, so that we do have that dedication and we are sporting ourselves and being able to fund our own sport, that we are in the top running to be able to be winners.
So then it's safe to say that our South African hockey players will do anything for hockey.
Basically, that's the best way to put it.
Alrighty, and then moving on to some roads hockey. Kaylee, so tell me, how has both the men and the women's team performed this season?
The men's and women's team both played a total of 11 games. The men won 3, the women won 2. The men lost 7 and drew 1, and the women lost 9. Okay. And the women and the women lost a total of 9. Their overall standings on the EP log for the men, they came 6 out of 7, and the women came 6 out of 8.
Alrighty, so that's the results from the season. And then can you tell us more about the results from USA that they played in this year?
Both the men and the women played in the B pool. They both placed 3rd as well. The women came behind UCT and Varsity College, and the men behind UKZN and Pokka.
Now every USA season we see some of the Rhodes players that will shine and kind of exhibit their talent and their skill in the area. Can you tell us about the men and the women's star players that were found this season?
On the men's team, Dean Ferreira, James Mariner, Ruru Masutu, Timothy Westwood and Richard Johnson all stood out as star players this year, with Dean Ferreira actually making the EP senior men's team. And then on the women's team, Carly Edworthy, Carolina D'Souza, and Rosemary DeBrain all made the senior women's EP team.
Sure, that's a whole bunch of good names. And then looking at rookie players, these are now Rhodes players who have come in first year, second year, third years, who have just started off but have still shown a very big jump in their talents. Can you tell us some of the names of the rookie star players?
On the men's team, Daniel Skolt, Cassidy Daniels, Rhys Westmeyer, and Wensie Radebe were all the first year players on the team. Were all the first time players on the team. And then Daniel and Cassidy were actually the only first year players that were put on the men's side this year. On the women's team, we've got Kelly Ebbing, Alison Brown, Jordan Fisher, Hannah Wood, Shanice Sias, and Snee Nene. They were all the first time players. And then Kelly, Alison, and Jordan were all first year players on the side this year.
Alrighty. And then I think the big question that we always ask, where to next for the men and women's teams for it?
I think they'll definitely both be looking to up their standings in the EP League next year. I think they'll both be searching for a pool win next year to maybe move up at USA.
Alright, so on to the next book.
Alright, thank you very much for watching this episode of Writer's Block, and thank you very much, Denise, for coming in. This will be our last episode for the year, but do stay tuned and keep an eye out for more Writer's Block episode next year.